This is CBS.
Tonight, Jane Byrne campaigns to win the support of Chicago labor leaders.
And a city employee tonight plans his own employee-paid retirement party. In perspective.
And a well-known athlete tries his hand at another sport, jockey Muhammad Ali. That's coming up next on the 10 o'clock news.
Here's a special value on our most successful car, Volare.
The car that combines room, ride, and comfort with manageable size. Buy any Volare with a value package of popular options like power steering and brakes, white walls,
wheel covers, AM radio with rear speaker, and digital clock, and you get an automatic transmission at no charge.
That's $318 off the sticker price.
A great car just got $318 better. See it now at any one of the 48 Chicagoland Chrysler Plymouth dealers.
Here's what kids say about Holsum bread. Hey, Lisa, what happens when you put peanut butter on Holsum bread?
You get a peanut butter sandwich.
Chris, what happens when you spread jelly on Holsum bread?
You get a jelly good sandwich.
Dawn, what happens to Holsum every morning?
It pops up all over town.
Holsum bread, the start of something good.
Which airline is number one across the Atlantic? The fact is, TWA flies more scheduled passengers to Europe and the Middle East than anyone. To places like London, Paris, Rome. The fact is, TWA has more flights to more cities across the Atlantic than anyone. To places like Athens, Madrid, the Middle East. And the fact is, TWA has over 100 wide-body flights a week across the Atlantic. TWA, number one across the Atlantic.
WBBM-TV, Channel 2, Chicago.
Bill Kurtis, Walter Jacobson, John Coughlin, and Johnny Morris. Channel 2, the 10 o'clock news.
Good evening. Mayoral politics continues to dominate the news. On the Democratic side, Jane Byrne tonight has won the backing of a major labor group. Byrne now is officially endorsed by the Chicago Federation of Labor and Industrial Union Council. That endorsement came at Musicians Hall this evening, and Kerry Cochran was there.
Labor leaders had lunched with Byrne on Monday, so tonight's gathering of rank and file was mostly formality. The resolution to endorse was unanimous, and the response to the candidate's entrance was resounding. Although Byrne's truce with labor is less than 24 hours old, one might have thought the alliance was a lifelong friendship from the tone of CFL President William Lee's introduction.
So here tonight, it is my pleasure, believe me, and I consider it a privilege, to present to you the next mayor of the city of Chicago.
But Byrne took nothing for granted tonight. She did more than thank the workers. She stayed to answer their questions and to put to rest their job insecurities under a new administration.
If I've done anything, I've come here tonight to pledge to you that the relationships that you enjoy with the late Mayor Richard J. Daley will certainly be continued if I am elected Mayor of Chicago.
Among the labor representatives present tonight was a spokesman for the Taxi Cab Drivers Union, who asked Byrne if she would continue to investigate irregularities in the taxi business, to which Byrne replied, quote, "That's what I came in on, that's what I went out on, and that was just a beginning." Bill?
Hey, man, I've been out of town for a day. Did the telegram ever get from Balandic to Byrne?
It somehow has not yet been located. Balandic's people say that they sent a telegram saying, "Congratulations on your nomination, best wishes to your family, Michael Balandic, mayor." It never apparently arrived at Byrne headquarters. Now the Balandic people are saying that they didn't send it to headquarters, they sent it to her home. So far, nobody's been home to collect it, so it's still a question, I suppose.
See, a mailgram, I guess, would solve all that. Thank you, Kerry. Byrne is mending fences with local Democratic Party leaders, too, meeting today with about a third of the city's 50 committeemen. They included Alderman Ed Burke and Ed Verdoliak, all of them as tight-lipped about the agenda as Central Committee Chairman George Dunn was tight-lipped.
How are you? Well, I might talk about the Cubs and the Sox and the Bears and the
Jane,
Bulls.
Jane Byrne,
Deep
you
Paul,
both have
Deep Paul,
on your
and Loyola, you know.
Channel 2 learned that Byrne used the meeting to answer questions, such as whether she might change her mind about firing Police Superintendent James O'Grady. No, she said, I believe O'Grady has politicized the police department. ask if she might keep Budget Director Ed Bedore and Patronage Chief Tom Donovan. I'm not going to fire everybody, she said. There will be no bloodletting, but I will choose my own cabinet. Regular Democrats have just started looking at taking a hard look, as a matter of fact, at where Jane Byrne stands on the major issues in Chicago, and it's the subject tonight of Walter's
and
perspective.
Many of those politicians are concerned, apparently, about where Jane Byrne is standing on the issues. Others are concerned about where Jane Byrne is standing on them. The politician Ed Quigley, for instance, of the 27th Ward, just west of the Loop, he is concerned that Jane Byrne is standing right smack on his future. Ed Quigley is a deputy commissioner in the city, water department. He's in charge of the Bureau of Sewers and in control of more than 900 city employees. Ed Quigley is the classic example of a political boss. He runs the West Side. He has kept the West Side the way it's been, empty and worn down. Ed Quigley has prevented the growth of the West Side. He has prevented the development of business and housing on the West Side in order to prevent a change in the nature of his constituency. Keep the West Side the way it is, and Ed Quigley can keep himself in control. If Jane Byrne is elected mayor, Ed Quigley is very likely to go. He'll be out of his job as chief of sewers, and possibly in 2 years he'll be out of his job as committeeman of the 27th Ward. And the word among the workers in the sewers is that Ed Quigley wants to go out in style. The workers are being called into meetings by their supervisors and being advised that a retirement party is being planned and that Mr. Quigley would like them all to attend at $50 each. They may not earn very much, the city workers in the sewers, but they're being told to come up with $50 nonetheless for a party for the boss. And they fear that if they don't, they may not be working in the sewers for very long. And that's $50 on top of the $45 that the workers in the sewers had to come up with for a party for Quigley at Christmas. It's expensive sometimes, working in the sewers.
Republican mayoral candidate Wallace Johnson also is getting some questions about who he will fire and who he'll keep if he wins the mayoral election. At a City Hall news conference, Johnson was asked about what he would do with the man who ran this winter's snow removal effort, Streets and Sanitation Commissioner Francis Degnan.
I don't even know Degnan, but I guess he's been competent.
You say his snow removal's been competent and you would keep him?
I beg your pardon?
You say his snow removal was competent and you would keep him?
No, I don't know about any of these things as far as the individuals are concerned. They might have made one or two mistakes. I have people in my brokerage business that make mistakes occasionally.
But he was responsible for the whole snow removal plan. Are you saying he was effective?
Well, I'm not saying that the snow removal plan was effective, certainly not. But I'm not saying that if you judge the man, are you going to ruin a fellow for the rest of his life for one error?
Johnson also says he doesn't like Byrne's idea that Chicago school teachers should be forced to live inside the city. He says city employees should be allowed to live in the suburbs if they want to. People in northern Illinois and Indiana are bracing themselves for some heavy flooding expected next week. We'll have that story after some messages.
All the news about energy hits home right here. Home heating oil supplies are tight these days. The people who make Amoco heating oil are doing what they can to help keep you supplied with fuel. But meanwhile, you can help by turning down the thermostat a few degrees. If you lower it 5 degrees at night, you could use about 5% less fuel. The more heating oil you can serve now, the more there'll be to go around.
Long Chevrolet in Elmhurst has Chevettes.
Our Chevette inventory is absolutely gigantic.
Long Chevrolet has every Chevette color, every Chevette option.
At any one time, we could have several hundred Chevettes in stock.
We have every model, every color, every conceivable option that Chevrolet produces.
The Chevettes are priced right at Long Chevrolet.
Giving the better deal has enabled us to become a volume dealer.
Every Chevette in stock now, Long Chevrolet, Elmhurst.
Time was when homes were simple and selling was fast. Then came electricity, plumbing, heating systems, central air, built-in appliances, making homes more complex. Now comes ERA with a valuable new idea. Home warranties that cover most working components before you sell or after you buy. Electronic Realty Associates, ERA. All you need to know in real estate.
Shiv and Shore brings you the fashion news for spring. New length tunics in Kiana over narrow pants. Easy, elegant two-piece Kiana dressing in beautiful prints and solids. And here, Ship and Shore says go sheer. Slip into the sheer prettiness of Ship and Shore's filmy new crepe tops. Ship and Shore Kiana and Ship and Shore Shears. What wonderful ways to look.
The Ship and Shore collection at Weibold State Street and near your home.
It's just into the newsroom. Another high-rise rental building has gone condo. Tenants at the Canelli Square complex in Old Town were notified tonight of the change. Canelli Square has 268 apartments. It's in the 1700 block of North Wells and North Clark. It had been one of the few high-rise rentals that were left on the near north side. The gasoline squeeze in this country feels a little tighter tonight. Two major airlines have announced service cutbacks. Others are keeping tabs on the situation. Let's go to Chuck Gomez now at O'Hare.
Tonight, as United and Delta Airlines prepared for tomorrow's cutback of flights due to the oil shortage, other airlines, such as American and Eastern, said they had no immediate plans to ground flights, but were keeping a close eye on the situation. United abruptly canceled 38 flights system-wide, 39 will be cut tomorrow, and 37 Thursday. So far, only a handful of flights out of O'Hare had been cut. But late this afternoon, a spokesman told Channel 2 News that in the next month, 429 flights will be grounded. In Chicago, that will affect some 50 flights a week. Meanwhile, Delta Airlines canceled 9 flights in and out of Chicago today.